Hi everyone, I'm Volika. Welcome back to the channel. Today I'm diving into two features that in my opinion are the true superpowers of Notion: relations and rollups. Honestly, it's hard to unlock the full potential of Notion without them. Stick around, I also share some hidden tricks that can take your workflow to the next level. Let's start with the basics. Relations allow you to connect two databases. For example, you can link a project's database to a task's database, so you can see which tasks belong to which project. Rollups take this further. They let you summarize or pull specific data from linked records. With Rollups, you could see how many tasks in project are marked as done, or calculate what percentage of a project is complete based on its tasks. Let's start by setting up two databases. If you don't know how to create one, check out my tutorial. The link is in the description. First, we'll create a task database with properties like name, person, status, priority, start date, end date. Next, we'll make a second database called projects, with these properties: activity code number, due date, priority, status, type of projects, owner. I also add a few simple tasks and projects to demonstrate how to use the relations feature. Now let's connect this database using a relation property. Add a new property by clicking the plus button. Select relation from the options. Choose a project's database to link to. Make sure to enable Show on Projects and confirm by pressing Add Relation. Now we can see that our two databases have new properties, projects and tasks. At this point, I can assign each task to a project by simply clicking on the cell and selecting the project from the list. Let me share a feature I absolutely love, but I notice not many people use it. When you click on the cell, you'll see a list of your projects. But what if you also want to see other properties, like the owner or the activity code number for each project? What do you do? You could use the Rollup property, which we'll explore later, but here's a quick way to view additional properties right in the list. Instead of selecting a project directly, click the three dots on the right side of the cell. This opens an explained list where you can click the eye icon to show extra properties like owner or activity code number. We don't see other properties directly in the table, but when we open the project page, you can view all the selected properties. It's a lifesaver if you have projects with similar names but need to differentiate them by their codes or their details. In some cases, this eliminates the need for a rollup because you can see all the relevant detail right on the page. Now, let's switch to the projects database. Here, we can see the linked task property, which shows all the tasks related to each project. This connection is two-way, meaning that we can assign tasks to project from here too. Even better, you can create a new task directly from the project database. Click on the cell in the task column. Type the name of your new task and select plus new. Now, this task is automatically added to both the project database and the task database. Let me share a few extra tricks. In order for our new tasks, then we create to be immediately with our icons, we need to use the template function. To do this, click on the arrow next to the new button and select new template. Select our icon and close the page. Then click the same arrow again and opposite our template. Click three dots and select set as a default. Now, when we create new tasks in the project database, we see this icon. You can customize the arrow icon in the relation property to a thumbstick you like better. Just click on the property, select the arrow, and choose a new icon. You can also set limits for linked pages. For example, if each tag should only belong to one project, go to the property settings and change no limit to one page. Here's another handy one. If your columns look scrubbed or cut off, click on the property name and select Wrap Column. This will let you see longer text or more details without realizing the column. Let's dive into Rollup properties and see how they can simplify tracking data between linked databases. Rollups work hand in hand with relations, allowing you to pull in and summarize specific data from connected databases. For example, with Rollups, you can calculate hotels, find the earliest or last dates, or display text or checkbox properties from related entries. Let's add a new Rollup property to your tasks. In your task database, add a new property by clicking the plus icon. Choose Rollup as a property type. Link it to your project's database using the relations we set up earlier. Select the property you want to summarize. For instance, if you want to see the due date of a project for each task, choose due date. Then decide what you want the Rollup to show, like the earliest date, the last date, or all related entries. Once configured, the Rollup will display the calculated or summarized data directly in your task databases. For example, you can easily see the due date of each related project besides its tasks. Let's simplify tracking project progress. I'll show you how to automatically calculate the percentage of a project completed based on its tasks without using any formulas. In the project database, create a new property and select Rollup. Link it to the task database through the relation. For property, choose status. And under calculate, select percent. Then set it to the percent per group and choose complete as a group. Now you'll see the percent of the completed tasks for each project. When you update a task in the task database to done, this percent updates automatically. Let's rename this property to percent progress to keep it concise and clear. Additionally, change the icon to something fits your workflow, like a progress bar or checkmark. If you click on a project in the task database, you can quickly access its full details by clicking on it again. This will take you directly to a project page, where you can view all of the related information and make any necessary changes. This feature is really handy for managing everything for a single place. And that's how you can use relations and rollups to manage projects and tasks effectively. Give it a try and let me know how you're using these features in the comments. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell for more notion tips. See you next time. Bye!